He's one of Australia's favourite cooks. From MasterChef to Taste of Australia, host Hayden Quinn is back in the kitchen. He's cooking for us today. What you making?
We're making an ugly banana bread in the blender. Really easy, super simple.
So good for lunches and everything. I love banana bread.
It is.
What makes yours so special?
Well, it's I'm not going to say it's quick because it does take a little bit of time baking, but it happens all in the blender. I'm not a baker.
Oh.
No. I don't like baking.
Yeah.
But this is easy and I always have...
Why don't you like baking? Because it has to be precise?
It's very precise and I don't really like too much sweet food. I love chocolate, but I don't like super sweet food. So this is like the way to use up... You know those dodgy bananas like the ones that I've got here?
Yes.
Worked out perfectly. It's a great way to use them up.
Smells so good.
Smash it up, get them in there. And I sort of wanted to riff off one of our Taste of Australia episodes we had on last week, where I met up with a lovely lady called Kerry Saunders, who does a lot of work with Australian natives. So this banana bread is going to have some wattle seed in there.
Nice.
If you guys want to just pass that around and have a little sniff, it's got a really nice roasty, toasty sort of flavour, which is quite delicious. It's got sort of a
coffee bean flavour. Wow, that's
coffee aroma.
Rich.
No, I was going to say, so Kerry is a Gomeroi woman who is obsessed with native grasses. There she is on the screen right now. And she works with Sydney Uni and they're doing an amazing job in sort of promoting these native ingredients, including the wattle seed, and hopefully pushing it out to more and more people. But this is sort of just taking, I guess, an entry-level native, like our wattle seed, and putting it in something that everyone knows, banana bread. It's a favourite across the whole family.
Okay, so back to the recipes. We've got, what, 4 bananas in there?
4 bananas. We've got 3 eggs.
Yep.
We've got some treacle. Now, little tip, treacle's super sticky, obviously.
Yep.
When you're using your spoon to get it out, give it a little spray with some sort of kitchen oil. Give it a quick spray, and then it won't stick. So
that's cool.
This tub has also been sprayed with a little bit of oil, so it'll come out a bit quicker and easier. Because, as we all know, treacle's so thick and sticky.
I've never used treacle in a banana bread recipe before. I love this.
Yeah,
I've been making them wrong.
And a whole
How much
of butter?
Yeah.
A lot of butter. Butter's good for you, surely. And then we've got a whole heap of brown sugar.
Okay.
And what else am I missing? I'm going to throw in some of our wattle seed, just a little pinch, just to add that flavour. Those whole wattle seeds there as well, we can use those too, but they're super, super hard. Again, amazing aroma. So if you want to use those to add sort of like a nice grain.
Crunch,
you just soak them for 24 hours so they soften up, but they give a really lovely lovely bite. So let's see if we can...
I was just going to say with that, like, was that the whole purpose of that Taste for Australia, going around and finding out these ingredients that you've never would have heard of before, I suppose?
100%. So we're very lucky. We get out on the land, we meet the farmers, we meet the producers, we meet people making and creating our food that we eat every single day and using interesting ingredients and sort of bringing it back to the masses, and people can watch on Channel 10 Sunday afternoon, 4:30 on the couch, might have a cold beer, and you're learning about stuff at the same time.
Exactly.
Gina, slice of banana cake, let's blitz it.
Exactly, let's give it a blitz. It was working before. There we go. So, like I said, really easy.
Why is it better to blitz it rather than just mix it like I do, with your hand, with a spoon?
Oh, I don't know, I'm a bit lazy sometimes.
You're also a master chef.
Does it make air races or something?
Yeah, obviously, once you get a little bit of air into that egg as well, the yolk's obviously going to get a little bit of love, but I'll give it a good whiz. And then all we need to do is get the flour in, which this could get a little bit everywhere.
Yes,
so, Sarah, be careful here.
All right.
There we go. Oh, it's hard. It's like fitting, what is it, a round peg in a square hole?
That's exactly what you're doing, isn't it? Do you want this thing?
Oh, yeah, that'll help. Genius.
Spatula?
Oh, yeah.
I think it's called.
You want this paddle? Do you want me to catch it with this?
There we go.
All right.
Okay, now what we're going to do is just give it a little...
Idea.
It's going to be worth it.
Yeah.
It's going to taste great.
Just bring it together nice and gently now, and then we're going to pop it in there, and we're going to have beautiful, delicious banana bread in the oven for about an hour. And away we go.
180?
180. Cook it away.
You don't even need to ask most of these days.
Don't you normally just put an oven on 180 and hope for the best?
Yes. We'd love to slice this up. And you've got to have it with butter as well.
We've got some butter there.
Tristan needs to ask you a question about bananas. Because we learned something
No, we heard this thing and I thought it was a bit weird, but then I was also into it, about bananas on the barbecue. I don't know where it came up. We were talking about it the other day.
I think I'm totally against.
Yeah?
Yeah, totally against. Me, myself, and I.
Yeah.
Myself and Danny Venn, when we were on MasterChef, we actually tried to do this in Melbourne on a charcoal barbecue, and it just did not work. It was too hot, they were burning, they were going mushy, it was really ugly. I'm all for bananas maybe in a pancake after a surf on a beach in Bali. That's very specific.
Yeah. But I like that too.
Warm bananas, that's where my head's going, but I think we keep the snags on the Barbie.
Keep the bananas off. You heard it from Hayden Quinn. No more Barbie, no more bananas on the barbecue. Taste of Australia.
How thick should a slice of banana bread be? Because
I like the gourd in them.
Taste of Australia, which tell everyone at home. It airs 4:30 p.m. right here on Channel 10.
Sure does.
Excited about this, Tristan.
Do you want in this? Come here, get your munchers around this one.
Yep.
How do you say it? There you go.
All right.